My name's Nader, and I make videos about Halifax, Nova Scotia, traveling and living abroad, and I talk a little bit about marketing. So if you want to learn about Halifax or you want to travel abroad, you should definitely subscribe to this channel and hit the little bell icon. It'll help you turn my notifications on so you don't miss an update. I give away free courses and a lot of value. So let's talk a little bit about something I never thought I'd talk about before. We've had a question from Anugra Masi, and if I just butchered your name, I'm sorry. Thank you for sticking around my channel. You probably didn't think I'm gonna go to his channel and get my name butchered, but there's a chance that I just butchered it, so sorry about that. Anyway, he asks, please make a video on how you and Mariah met. Mariah is the girlfriend that I moved down to Halifax with, and also dating advice for international students. And I thought a little bit about how to answer this, so I'm gonna answer the simple thing first. I met Mariah in band in Lakefield, Ontario at my high school, Lakefield District Secondary School. I was in grade 9, she was in grade 11, and we both played the saxophone. Now, we started dating when I was in grade 10, so she was in grade 12. This is a high school thing. We went on a band trip, and we just decided, you know what, we're gonna date. And then after that, a couple years go by, I'm looking for a university, she's at Trenton University. We said, hey, why don't we just pick up and go all the way to Halifax? So we came from Ontario, moved to Halifax, and now we're here. So that's as simple as I can put it. But in terms of international students, dating advice, do I look like Montel Williams? Do I look like I can give dating advice? Am I Oprah Winfrey? In fact, I would consider myself a combination of Montel Williams, Oprah Winfrey, and Dr. Phil with a little bit of the zest of, who's very zesty? I don't know, my own zest. Anyway, international students, I'd say dating advice would be like anywhere else. I know a lot of people in Halifax are on Tinder, that's a huge thing. I think that's kind of silly. You can call me old-fashioned, but I'm certainly not, because I run a digital marketing agency and I make videos almost every day, so I'm not old-fashioned. You can eat it. I feel like personally people are a little bit judgmental, and in order to break that wall, in order to break the barriers, you need to be in person to do that. So I would suggest, like, I don't know, I feel like when you make a Tinder or an online dating profile, people are going to be judgmental. They're gonna rate you solely on looks. But I'm a charismatic motherfucker. So if, like, I wanted to, like, talk to somebody, I would recommend doing that in person. So if you're looking to date someone, you're an international student, use your international charm, use your exoticness to meet new people. Don't just make a Tinder. I mean, if you really want to, you can do that, and then it will probably boost your chances. But at the same time, I feel like it's a waste of time, because instead of going out, you're just swiping, 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 and waiting for the people who are unsuperficial to just, yeah, I mean, or you can get a superficial person, I don't know. But I feel like I can also gauge what the other person is like. I mean, on online dating apps, you're not really gonna be able to gauge the personality as much. And everybody is like, tell me about your cat, put your favorite food in there, you better like sushi and stupid stuff like that. So I rather just meet people in person, speak to them, form that connection, and then I know. Cause like, you talk to someone and you're like, hey, what's up, how are you feeling? And they're like, I'm good, and they don't look at you, then I'm like, oh, I'm getting out of here. You know, so you can really have that opportunity. Second piece of advice I give you as an international student looking to date people is don't be afraid, okay? Don't be afraid of other people. I get you have a little bit of fear inside. You may be like, oh, Canada's scary, Canada new. It's not that scary, it's not that new. You're gonna get used to Halifax quickly. Talk to as many people as possible. It will increase your chances, boost your confidence, and you gotta get out there. You only live once. You wanna be 85 and say, oh, I only try talking to 2 or 3 people. I wish I could be 20 again. I wish I could be 18 again. I wish I could be 25 again. You don't wanna be that person. So go out there, give it your all, listen to your gut feeling, and Do the unconventional. Don't do what other people are doing. If everyone's focusing on like online dating, same thing goes with business. If everybody's focusing on saving money, start spending it. If everyone's focusing on spending money, start saving it. Start doubling down on what other people aren't doing. It may be more difficult to meet people because you come from a different country, but you can also use that to your advantage. So try your best to do that. Please subscribe to this channel if you're an international student or you just want advice. We're building a tribe here. What we're trying to do is move beyond Halifax videos, branch out a little bit, and talk about moving internationally. Talk about why it's important to get out there. So I really appreciate your input and advice. Tell me in the comment section below what you'd like to see in the new video, and again, be sure to subscribe.